While big tests are a major focus for any sport walker, building challenge into your everyday walking is great for keeping your motivation high all the time, not just when you're training for a challenge event. So here are some different short challenges that you can build into your everyday walks, and they're all mainly designed to be done on road, so you can spice up your walks as often as you like. Possibly the most common everyday challenge I'll take on is what I call the hunter-gatherer. The premise is really simple. You take a rucksack and walk to your local supermarket to get a few supplies. You want a reasonable list of things to pick up, so you get to carry a fairly decent load back home. But don't try and do a full weekly shop, because you want to avoid carrying things in your hands. You walk to the supermarket, keeping a strong pace. Not flat out, but a good strong pace. Then, weighted down with your shopping in your rucksack, you walk back home, keeping as close as you can to the speed you walked at on the way out. The hunter-gatherer is great for building leg strength because of the weight you're carrying, but also because you're trying to keep the same pace on the way back as you did on the way out with that extra weight, it's also giving you an aerobic hit, so it'll give you general fitness benefits as well. If you live in an extra-urban or semi-rural environment, chances are you'll have some short sections of footpath dotted around your neighbourhood. For this challenge, plot a route on roads that links all of these fragmented trails or footpaths together to build a single route where you walk all the trails or paths in your neighbourhood, and use the road network to go from path to path. I did this where I lived, and I managed to come up with a route that was over 16 kilometres or 10 miles long, so you can create some pretty decent short challenge routes just within your local area. In the last show, we talked about measuring your top speed, but there's another measure that's really useful to know, and that's your 10k or 6 mile pace. This is because the pace you can walk 10k or 6 miles at is a pretty good measure of what you're likely to be capable of for a marathon or 50k. So in a normal training session, walk 10k or 6 miles and set your baseline short challenge pace. When you're setting your own challenges rather than just taking part in an organised event, you want to have as much variety as you can just to keep things interesting. And taking on an urban challenge is a great way to do something different. By urban, I don't mean just walking through a housing estate or retail park. I mean picking a town or city centre with many interesting places of interest and plenty of open spaces like parks or gardens, and then creating a challenge route that takes in all of these places. Points of interest are like your checkpoints, and you can plot the most green and interesting route through the town or city that leads you to all the best places. You'll probably struggle to plot a route that's ultra distance, but many cities now have their own marathon races, so why not just piggyback your challenge onto the route of a city centre marathon? The organisers will have included all the most interesting spots, because that's what makes for an enjoyable route and keeps people coming back. So save yourself some legwork and use their route map as your guide. Similar to the All the Paths challenge is one where you seek to make a complete circumnavigation of your local area. Instead of taking a route from point to point to use trails or footpaths, this time plot a circular route that leads all the way around the area that you live in. You may go beyond your actual local area, but it's all about what you feel is your local patch and circumnavigating that. With all these challenges, you're seeking to complete them in the shortest time you can, and you also want to apply yourself in exactly the same way as you would for an organised event, taking consideration for your fueling and your hydration. You want to make this just like taking on any other challenge. It's just that it's making use of all the resources in your local area to build challenge into your everyday walks.